Good evening, everyone.
Welcome.
I want to thank John Winthrop for sponsoring this event and the Coastal Conservation League. Thank you, Dana, and all your folks. As you know, it's entitled Old City High Water. What an appropriate topic name. We are an old city, and if you look at the old maps of Charleston, you'll see a very different picture than what you see today, because many wetland and marsh and creek areas were filled in over the last nearly three and a half centuries. And in fact, that's where most of our worst flooding occurs, because we didn't have the knowledge and the land planning that we needed as the city developed. So another old part of our city, we had, I'm so proud and love the job of serving as the 61st mayor of Charleston. I think he was the 39th mayor. Henry Pinckney was the mayor in 1839. And he offered a $100 gold coin to anyone who could solve the drainage problems of Charleston. I found that coin in my desk after Mayor Riley's career. We all know we have a challenge in front of us. I met Jamie this afternoon, by the way. You're in for a treat. He's so knowledgeable about this topic and has some great information to share with us. And I shared with him a little story that just a week before last, Mark Wilbert and Laura Cavanis and I went up to Columbia to meet with Governor McMaster, because we were urging him to help us with the federal government get approval for this long-standing mitigation grant that we've had in for now almost 2 years to help buy out some repetitive flooding properties west of the Ashley. And he looked at me, by the way, we spent a whole hour with him, which I thought was great. He asked a lot of questions, and he was very interested. He got an education on drainage and problem and flooding challenges in Charleston. But he looked up and he said, I guess Irma was a wake-up call for you. And I said, no, sir, it wasn't. We've been working on this. In fact, I gave Jamie a copy of the presentation that was made this past July at City Council Workshop, about a 100-page presentation of what the city of Charleston is doing for resiliency. And I've known about our challenges, of course. I've lived here all most of my life, as many of you have, but where it really hit me side to face was a year ago when Hurricane Matthew was coming to town. And it was a direct, you know, hit, even though, thank God, it was only a Category 1 storm when it got here. But the key thing that really saved us was that it came at dead low tide. And so when I was down at the Emergency Operations Center, and we had video cameras set up around the city just to see what was going on, and about 2 weeks prior to that, I, with Jason Kronberg, our capital projects guy, had been down at the seawall to mark on there how high we were going to build the new wall up to. And I'm sitting there, and it's low tide, and water is coming in over where we had marked on the wall to where we were going to build it up to. And I said, we need to redo this plan for this wall and make it higher and make it sustainable and be able to add on to it and all like that. So anyway, the wake-up call had been made some time ago. We got challenges ahead of us. We're all going to work on it. And thank you again for being here, Jamie, and Dana for putting this on, and John for sponsoring it. Thank you all for being here.